today the new thing on the block, the new kid on the block, is Turkish and or Korean eggplants. They are very hardy eggplant, very meaty, and have a traditional eggplant flavor. I like them a lot.
How do you cook those?
Well, eggplants, you usually salt them, let a little bit of water out of them, and then you can bake them, fry them, cook them in tomato sauce.
So you cook this
a million
exactly
ways.
The same way you cook the other eggplants?
Yes.
Ah.
Except this is much heartier, much more traditional flavor of eggplant.
What about this one? This is just...
This is a... got pinched between two stems, and that's why it's got those marks there. This is basically a purple Italian eggplant. A little bit milder flavor and whiter flesh. First picking of a red-colored artichoke. And this is kind of early for us. I love the flavor on baby artichokes.
Haifa and Zaid, love those guys. Tilly's also my dude. This place is awesome.
What vegetables do you like?
Right here, we're doing cucumbers. We're working on a watermelon panzanella. So we're doing cucumber, fresh watermelon, toasted bread. So should be fun.
Watermelons. These are high tunnel watermelons. That's why they're real early. I had one last night, very nice and flavorful. Of course, these are the seeded variety, which I prefer over the seedless.
How do you pick a good watermelon?
How do you pick a good watermelon? Well, there's a couple of different ways. These ones were hanging, so you cannot use the traditional method, which is you look at the bottom of the watermelon, and there's usually a yellow spot.
Right.
If it's resting on the ground. That's one indication of it being ripe. Now, these are hanging up, so you can't use that method. So you use the thumping method. Now, it's kind of a hollow sound, and you get used to, once you've done it a couple of times, you know what that sound is. That's what I use for picking my watermelon. Plus, I know by looking at them.
Can you pick another one up? Let's see if that thumps differently.
Not really.
Yeah.
Good.
I'll be going for that one.
Now this one,
that's a little higher.
Is a little denser.
Yeah.
So they may be slightly more ripe, but it may or may not affect how sweet they are. The next thing that's coming along is going to be melons, such as our Charente and Honeydew melons. We're at Union Square Friday, Saturday, and Monday. See you at the market.
Bye. Hi there, can I ask you what you're cooking this week with the fava beans?
I'm going to make foo madamas, so I'll shell them and steam them open and then cook them very lightly in a little bit. I have these garlic scapes that I ground up, I'll throw that in and a little bit of lemon, and then I'll put tahini and burnt onions on top.
How do you pick a fava bean?
Well, these are really good size. I mean, these are beautiful. So the favas will be pretty good size. So, you know, you want them to look still pretty green. They're such a delicacy. I mean, to get fresh favas is really a treat. Oh yeah, look at the size of these. Just look at the size of those fava beans. I mean, that's really beautiful. These are really healthy plants. You can make the favas in a puree, but which is nice. It's like a very nice spread and a dip, but I don't know, the foo is so good. But maybe I'll put them in a salad. I made them before my father died, the last meal I made for him, I made fava beans,
really?
Which he loved. And so it makes me think about him too. So, you know, cooking is culture. Food we share. It's nice. Thanks.
Thank you so much.
These greens came from one source, but split into many. These greens hold an abundance to be eaten by plenty. Vibrant in color, rich in nutrients, high in standards, these greens are a gift from the Creator. The next time you are shopping for your food source, remember to eat them with gratitude.